you're having a little trouble. Are you sending a saga? So I thought that if we could rehearse it, then you might understand it better. Now, you can be Gisa.
Gisa said to Gudmundur, go away.
Go, Gudmundur. Leave me. Save yourself.
Hi guys, the house is on fire. Why are we in the dairy?
We can't all stay. Go, leave me, be free and happy. Live your lives, think of me.
Gisa flung down away from him his coat of mail and his steel helmet and a green sword in his hand. He went to the Skirbats and flung his sword in it. He saw another vat on the floor with a vat on top of it and space that a man might sit in it. He sat down in the sour way in nothing but his linen lingerie. The sour way went all the way up to his nipples. He sat in there for a while and then heard people say that if he were found, three men would be chosen to butcher him slowly and see how he liked it. Harney, Kolbein and Ari were chosen. They searched the dairy.
No, I can't see him. No, he's not here.
The four of them stuck their spears into the vat, giving Gisa many small wounds.
I'm dying from paper cuts.
But they couldn't find him. Gisa was so cold that he shivered and the spear gurgled. They left.